Here is a little sample of the broomstick lace that I worked up on the machine. And thanks to Badia for reminding me how it was done. Now, she used a ruler similar to this. I did try that here on my bulky machine. I couldn't get the stitches quite big enough. And then, with that sample there, I had used a paper towel core. But it still looks a little bit big. So I cut it and just brought it in, made it a little bit smaller to use it. And it does look a little bit better right now. So I already have the first one done here. And what I did was, of course, I did some waste yarn because I want to have the material to hold on till later. My cast-on comb is on there for the weight. I knitted two rows. The carriage was on the right. And then what I did, as you see the yarn here, was I took and I hand-knitted each stitch, took it off of the needle, and I pulled the loop up and wrapped it around the tube here. Then I did the next needle. And sometimes I have to hold it here just to hold that stitch down, the work down. Sometimes when that stitch is too big, it doesn't want to come off just right. And after you get a couple stitches on the core, you really don't have to hold it. The first one, I found it a little bit too loose. Now, I found with the tape on here, it makes it nice and slippery. So I probably should have the whole core taped. Or if you could find something, this was 1.5 inches. I was going to try this, but it's basically the same width, just a little bit more. But with the handle on there, I wouldn't be able to do a whole thing. The other thing I was going to try was my garter bar, the standard one, with this little garter guard on there. But that, I think, made it too wide. I have just over 2 inches. So, depending on your machine, the yarn you're using, you need to find whatever's going to work for you. So I go down the line. Now I only have 20 stitches. I had 15 on that other one. And I do try to take the front of the loop and put it so it's on this side facing me. So as I pull it up, I know this is the front part. I feel the yarn going through my fingers. And then I put it on the tube. After a while, I do have to push it down. So I'm going to finish up the rest of these. Well, it looks like I'm already at needle 5. So I've got 15 more of these loops to do. Now the last stitch is pretty easy because I just pull it through and leave that needle out. And then what I do is, because this was the end needle, I'm going to take two more out, but skip in a needle. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I take 5 loops off. I make sure those latches are open. And I hang the loops on the hooks. Now I take the next one, skip one, next one, skip one, next one. Again, making sure the latches are open. Take the next 5 loops off. And hang them on the hooks. And this is where the weights come in handy. Whether it's just the cast-on comb, or if you have claw weights on. Now, I don't like splitting the yarn. So if I split the yarn, I just make sure that it goes all right. And here you see one of the loops came off. Next, what I do is I take my three-prong tool and I push down. So I'm pushing the work between the needles down all across. And then I push the work behind the latches. Now, if this is the bond machine, of course, you have to make sure the latches are open and push your needles back into the forward working position. Now I need to pull my yarn back up through the yarn mast because I do pull a lot of it out just to do that. Now I knit, I think it was three rows I did knit. Yeah, because I want the carriage to end up over here. Now I'm going to be wrapping those again, but before I do that, I have my carriage set to hold, so I can push my carriage across. And it's still, well, I don't have my counter going. But it would, if I had the tripper on, I would know how many rows I'm doing. But basically, well, I started out with two, and then the third row is the loops, and then I did three rows. So it's a combination of, well, the first one is three rows, and then after that it's four rows. And that's all there is to it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do my gate peg bind off and cut the yarn. I'm going to keep the two samples just to show the difference between the larger core and the smaller core. It's really what kind of a loop you're looking to get. This one really isn't that bad. I did forget to mention that after I get all the loops on and I knit across, you don't want to pull it up too much because you have this space here. So you want to just hold the yarn good enough that it's not pulling that up and scrunching that one row. To show you how I do that, I basically just hold the yarn above the carriage. It's kind of loose. Once I feel it catch, then I let the yarn go. Well, if it's too loose up above, I may have to still hold it. But you don't want to pull this up tight for that first stitch. And there. So I'm going to finish this off and take it off the machine and show you the difference between this one and the first one I made. So there they are. Now you could see how the first one with the larger loops is almost as tall as this one here, and also how it's tighter at the bottom here and then on the side. Now I think this would make a really nice scarf if I was to do probably 6 or 8 sets of loops. It looks like it's not curling too much. If it does curl, then either line it with a piece of material or just steam it, and I'm sure you can get it to lay flat. Again, thanks to Badia for this.